Hello, I'm Kurt Owen, and you're not?
I'm not.
But you're my lovely wife, Terry Owen. She is awesome. I was just telling her in between the cuts how much easier this is when she's here, because you've got so many good things to say, plus you're really nice to look at, and you have a lot of wisdom that helps people and helps me.
So what we've been talking about is the uncertain times.
Oh, I'm talking about you, and you want to switch subjects.
And so, to be honest with you, I have been so grateful to sit under the ministry that Pastor Kurt has had, because it has changed my life, and it's changed my relationship with God. It's changed my perspective on the way to look at things. I used to be so insecure. I used to be so uncertain on things. And I know that some people who may have known me for a long time knew me as a confident person, but the reality was my confidence was shallow. And the longer that I sat under this ministry, the longer that I started to let the word of God get down on the inside of my heart, the more that my life changed. And my confidence is not as easily shaken. And I'm not saying it never gets shaken. And we don't want to pretend that, Right. Hey, you know, we're super giants and we never do anything wrong. It's not that. It's that we have this anchor that pulls us back. Mm-hmm. And so even if something tries to get us off track, we have the word of God that brings us back. And you've taught us that. You've taught us to be rooted and grounded in the word of God and to look to Jesus for all of our answers. And this is one of the scriptures that you helped to change my life by looking at and saying, listen, God's not questionable.
Oh, right, right.
And even when things do start to look like they get worse, mm-hmm. you need to take a stand, and you need to say, listen, I'm going to stand here and I'm going to believe. And really,
Amen.
As believers, what else do we have left to do?
Amen.
But believe.
Now, where do you end up if you make this decision to decide that you do not live in uncertain times? When you make this decision that God is true, mm-hmm. that though He is sovereign and though He is all powerful, He is a God of honor and a God of integrity. Where do you end up? Well, we can see it. Mm-hmm. So we've been talking about from Daniel chapter 3 with
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
And they're threatened by Nebuchadnezzar.
Because he had created a false god.
Right.
He wanted them to sit down, you know, bow down and worship. And some people who were jealous turned them in and said, hey, these guys aren't doing what you said to do. And then he got infuriated. He calls them in. And in that moment, they have an opportunity to make a choice. He gives them a choice. He says, hey, if you bow down and worship, then all is well. And if you don't, then you're going to get thrown into the fiery furnace.
And so here is, and that's the thing they're thrown out to them. If you fall down and worship the God, everything's great. If you don't, we're throwing you into the burning fiery furnace. And so this is where the famous if statement comes up from Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. We'll start in verse 16. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If that is the case, again, God is not mentioned here yet. God has not been brought into the situation. When they say, if that is the case, I think New King James says, if it be so.
Right.
They're talking about being thrown into the burning fiery furnace. They're talking about the king. They're not talking about God. Because when they begin to talk about God, they begin to establish completely, sir, we live in certain times.
Right.
We're uncertain about you,
Right. But
we're not uncertain about God.
Amen.
And he says, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O king. Mm-hmm. But if not, is he talking about if God doesn't deliver us, or is he talking about this is the second part of the if?
Right. So there's always an if and an if not.
Right. And the first if is if you throw us into the furnace. Therefore, the second is if you don't throw us into the burning fiery furnace. And then he says, let it be known to you, O king, that we do not serve your gods, nor will we worship the golden image which you have set up. Which again, this only comes into questions is if they're still alive.
Right.
In other words, if they're not thrown into the furnace. Because if they're dead, if they've been thrown into the burning fiery furnace, nobody's sitting around at the dinner table wondering Right. Whether they worship these gods. But here's the question. What happens, and we talked about, we'll get into it in a second. What happens to the person when you make a decision that I am going to be certain about God? Because it does take a choice.
Absolutely.
That's where it starts off.
Right.
It starts off that I'm going to believe God in His Word. Now again, and I think you pointed out this out very well, this wasn't Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego's first faith project. That's
Right. A
lot of Fs right there. That wasn't their first time trusting God.
Right.
These are governors of places. They had enough confidence in God that they knew he was God, and that gold fake thing is not.
Right.
And so this where do you end up though? But it all starts with a decision. I'm going to believe you. I'm going to believe your word. And now I'm going to put it into practice.
And one of the things that you always talk to us about when we are talking about us walking by faith is that we don't start believing God for $1 million.
Correct.
You always told us, start believing God for a pair of socks. Start believing God for an extra $5 a week so that you start to increase your confidence in your faith, so that as we're walking by faith, it's not, oh my goodness, we're faced with a plague and now all of a sudden you're being asked to believe
right.
God's word.
Right.
And so we put the word of God down on the inside of us, but then we practice it daily.
Or to give a biblical example, you don't start running out fighting Goliath. Fight the lion,
right.
Fight the bear. And then you'll find yourself ready to fight Goliath. And then after Goliath, the entire army.
Right. And that's where we are with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. So King Nebuchadnezzar gets absolutely infuriated that they refuse to bow down. And he says, hey, listen, you guys fire this furnace up 7 times more than it usually
yeah,
is.
Yeah, it does not. This is not what happened. We trust God. We believe God. Oh, that's okay. Never mind. We'll let you go. No, it gets worse.
It gets worse. The reality looks worse.
Yeah. And
the consequences look worse.
And this is where you're going to have to hold fast to what you have learned up to this point. Hold fast to the word of God. Now, and again, let me just be clear. You know, we talk about believing God for a pair of socks, believing God for $5. At the beginning, the socks might look to you like a burning fiery furnace.
Right.
The lack of the $5 might look to you like a burning fiery furnace. Mm-hmm. You're still going to have to make the same decision in that moment
right.
that you're going to have to make when you end up here,
right.
when it's a house, $1 million, a building, you know, paying for off a church or whatever it might happen
right.
to do. You still have to make a choice. I trust God. I'm not backing off.
Right.
But don't have in your mind, I'm going to start my walk of faith and then everything's going to be great.
Right.
Everything's going to be fine. I'm never going to have another problem. No, you're going to have, I like to say it like this. You might have $100 worth of problems, but there'll always be $100 there to answer the problem.
Right.
It's the easiest way to
right.
describe it. So,
so here what we see is that things get worse for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They take the stand. They refuse to back off. They refuse to bow down. They refuse to face reality. And so then they have...
Things get worse.
The king tells, you know, 7 times hotter than usual. And then also, mighty man of valor, go ahead and tie up Shadrach.
Yeah, yeah, make sure they can't escape. Get my best guys in here to hold on to them. To make sure they can't run away.
Right. So at this point, if you're Shadrach, Meshach, and again, Abednego, if you are not confident in what the word
I thought
said,
God was going to deliver us. I thought God was going to help us.
Panic's going to rise up on the inside of
you. But they didn't panic, but they do get bound. Then these men were bound in their coats and their trousers and their turbans and their other garments and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace.
Now take a look at this. So the consequence actually happens.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, it happens.
Now we know how hot the fiery furnace is because of the
what
next
happened?
Verse.
Yeah, therefore because of the king's command was urgent, the furnace exceedingly hot, the flame of fire killed those men, these mighty men, who took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Okay, now look at this. Now, this is amazing, right? So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego should have perished at the moment that they get the furnace.
Yeah, get close to it. Because
the other guys did.
Yeah, because the other guys are dead, and they're not even going into the burning fiery furnace.
They're around it.
Yeah, and they're dead. It's killing mighty men. Now, you know, think about that with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Again, dude, that guy's much mightier than I am, and he just died.
Right.
Oh my God, what's going to happen to me? That wasn't where they were at. Now, again, this is important too. They were bound.
Mm-hmm.
They're tied up. They are at the mercy of the king. So then they get thrown into the fiery furnace.
Mm-hmm.
There, and then it says, and these three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down, bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Now, again, they're thrown in like wood, right? They're like, throw them in because they're bound. And so they actually fall down in the fire, on the fire. This is not them standing on it. This is them laying down on it like it's a bed. And so they're laying down there. And then Nebuchadnezzar was astonished, and he rose in haste and spoke, saying to his counselors, "Did we not cast three men bound into the midst of the fire?" They answered and said to the "True, O king, look." He answered, "I see four men loose and walking around in the midst of the fire, and they are not hurt. And the fourth, the form of the fourth is like the Son of God."
God will show.
Oh my goodness! They've thrown into the fire. It's killed these other men. They have been cast down, mm-hmm. bound. Mm-hmm. But something happens. Mm-hmm. They stand up. And they are standing there free in the midst of the fire.
And they're just walking around with
you. And they're just walking around with the Lord. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're not heading. It doesn't say they got free and headed towards the entrance. Mm-mm. They're in the furnace walking around saying, "Well, this is different." And say, "Well, he can't get in here to us because his mightiest men are dead laying outside. We're doing fine.
We're doing fine. My God has delivered me."
Yeah, we are standing here in the midst of the fire. A lot of times people say, "Yeah, but that's just too scary for me." Listen, you live in certain times. You need to make a decision. My God is greater than the fire. Even if I stand in the fire, I'm not going to be burned. I'm not going to be changed. Oh, man, we didn't get all the way through this.
And here's an important thing with that too, right? They didn't know how God would deliver them.
Right.
They didn't know at what point God would deliver them. They just knew He would.
He will. He will. Yes. We're going to have to pick up on here next time. We're out of time. We hope you're getting something out of this. Listen, even if you're headed to the furnace, even if you get thrown into the furnace, right. It's not over yet. And for these men, they were safer in the furnace than out because Jesus is always with them. Amen. Yeah. We love you guys very, very much. Remember, Jesus is risen and victory is assured.